So if you can see here, I'm just on a page on the 3Play Media website that has a video here and an interactive transcript here. So the interactive transcript is everything included in this box here. So in this case, it's to the right of the video player, but you'll also see other implementations where it might be below the video player or somewhere else on the page. So the interactive transcript is hooked up to the video player, and they work together to create the interactive experience. The video player is separate from the transcript, and there are many different types of video players. Some that you might have heard of are YouTube, JW Player, Vimeo, Brightcove, Kaltura, Vuyala, Wistia, and our plugins will work with all of those video players and more, which I probably didn't mention, but I'll show you that list later on. Okay, so what exactly do we mean when we say interactive? If this transcript was not interactive, it would just be, you know, just be a block of text below the video. The transcript is interactive in the sense that you can, you know, interact with it to control your viewing experience. So one of the most basic yet useful features is the ability to use the transcript to navigate through the video. So for example, you could read ahead in the video, in the transcript, sorry, and then select somewhere to stop playing the video from. Another really useful feature is the search. So for example, I could search for the word mobile here. And you can see that it is mentioned at each of these points in the timeline. And a lot in this section right here. So I could click here in the timeline and the video will jump to that point. And you'll see all of the results of mobile highlighted in the text too. So there are some other features as well. One of those is this clipping feature. This allows you to share a link to a specific clip from the video. So if I highlight a block of text and click the clipping icon here, I have a few options of how I want to share this link. And when I do share it, the video will automatically start playing from this point in the video. Other features are print. This allows you to print a copy of the transcript. There's also the option to download the transcript to your computer. You can see that saving down there. There's also this little icon here lets you collapse and expand the transcript. And we also have the scan view feature. So if I enable scan view, you can see that some of the words are bigger than others. And these words are scaled according to how frequently the words occur in the transcript and also the significance of the words in relation to the rest of the transcript.